Ireland during the medieval period was made up of many independent kingdoms ruled by Irish chieftains, but after the Normans from England came to Ireland in the 12th century, they began establishing domains of their own across Ireland. Over the centuries, the English introduced laws which sought to erode the Brehon laws, the old Gaelic system of land ownership, the status of poets and chroniclers, and indeed the Gaelic-Irish lifestyle, language and culture. Donegal at that time was still an independent Gaelic kingdom known as Tyrconnell, ruled by the O'Donnells, who had kept the Normans out of their domain. Various other families served the O'Donnells, such as the McSweeneys, Gallaghers, Wards and O'Clearys. The O'Donnells were wealthy from trade with England and continental Europe. Like many European leaders, they were well-travelled, well-educated, and here they were well-connected with other leading Irish and Scottish nobility, although this didn't stop many internal battles over territory. When English King Henry VIII split from the Roman Catholic Church, he created his own Church of England, the Anglican Church, and with that he stripped the Catholic Church of its power across the British Isles, including Ireland, stealing gold and treasures, destroying many monasteries, and converting many cathedrals. The Carmelite Abbey in Rathmullen, County Donegal, became a refuge for many fleeing monks. Ireland was reorganised into the Kingdom of Ireland. Whoever was King of England would also be King of Ireland. When Henry VIII's daughter Mary became Queen, she attempted a plantation of English settlers to go and live in Leash and Offaly, but it was a failure as the English settlers felt too threatened by the Irish living close by. After Queen Mary died, her half-sister Elizabeth became Queen, and she attempted a plantation in Munster, confiscating the land of the powerful Desmond dynasty. Queen Elizabeth I was a strong follower of the new Anglican Church and sought to spread it throughout what she saw as her kingdom. Ireland, it would seem, needed to be tamed. By the 1590s, most of the Irish leaders had been defeated, had submitted to English rule, or had had their lands confiscated for the plantations. Only Ulster, where the Brehon laws still held sway, stood against the English. The province had a strong defence, as the only two decent ways to march an army into it was through Sligo or Newry. Everywhere else in between was hills, forests, lakes and or bogs. Its leaders were O'Neill of Tyrone, O'Donnell of Tyrconnell and Maguire of Fermanagh. The English tried many tactics to put pressure on the northern chieftains, including the kidnapping of Red Hugh O'Donnell, who was visiting his McSweeney cousins in Rathmullen. He was held hostage in Dublin for 4 years, from which he eventually escaped. While staying with Cuconnacht Maguire of Fermanagh on his way home, he began building allegiances for his war against the English and the defence of Ulster. Thus began the 9 Years' War. While Hugh O'Neill initially helped the English, hoping to become Lord President of Ulster, Queen Elizabeth refused him this title, thinking him too independently minded. O'Neill joined forces with Hugh O'Donnell, and the war kicked up a gear. O'Donnell and O'Neill contacted King Philip II of Spain to help in their fight against the English, whom Spain had been fighting for years. Eventually, in 1601, his son and successor, Philip III, sent a Spanish fleet landing 3,500 soldiers on the wrong end of the country, by the walled town of Kinsale on the Cork coast. English commander Lord Mountjoy sent 12,000 troops to lay siege to the Spaniards in Kinsale. O'Donnell and O'Neill had to march their army of 7,000 men the whole length of the island to relieve the Spanish in the middle of winter. What should have been a massive Irish attack on a sick and hungry English army turned into a complete disaster as the Irish were surprised on approach by an English cavalry charge. The Battle of Kinsale was fought on the 24th of December 1601 of the Julian calendar, and the Irish were defeated, ending any hope of Irish victory in the 9 Years' War. What Irish forces survived returned to Ulster with Hugh O'Neill to continue the defence. Hugh O'Donnell stayed with the Spanish and returned to Spain with them, where he would hopefully raise a new army and return. But he died a year later, probably poisoned by an English spy. Hugh's brother, Rory O'Donnell, continued to defend Tyrconnell. But amidst famine from ravaged lands and the desertion of allies, neither O'Donnell or O'Neill could hold back the English tide. Hugh O'Neill, Earl of Tyrone, surrendered at Mellifont, County Louth, at the end of March 1603, renouncing the Irish title, the O'Neill, and giving up all lands and lordships to the crown. The surrender happened barely a week after the death of Queen Elizabeth, unknownst to O'Neill at the time. Because she had died without an heir, her cousin, James VI of Scotland, became James I of England, and he decided to do things a little differently. Rather than punishing O'Neill, he restored his title of Earl, and made Rory O'Donnell Earl of Tyrconnell as well. But they soon discovered that they had little real power, and they'd have to abandon the old Brehon laws and Gaelic way of life, not to mention the constant threat of being accused of treason. So, on the 14th of September 1607, they set sail from Rathmullen. 99 people, including the O'Neills, O'Donnells, Maguires, O'Gallaghers, McDevitts, Wards, Plunketts, Tullys, McSweeneys, McGuinnesses, O'Kanans, and others. They left for Spain, where they had hoped to raise an army and retake Ireland, but they never returned, and this departure became known as the Flight of the Earls. Storms at sea prevented them from landing in Spain, and so they ended up on the French coast. The French king didn't want to offend the English by allowing the Earls to pass through France to Spain, so they were sent to Spanish Netherlands instead, where they were treated like royalty, entertained by the Archduke Albert and Isabel, met Marcus Spinola, commander of the Spanish army, and other leaders. Early in 1608, they set out on a long journey south to Rome, passing through Belgium, Switzerland, and Italy. While crossing the Alps, they lost a large sum of money off Devil's Bridge, going through St. Goddard's Pass, on St. Patrick's Day, no less. By the time they reached Rome on April 29th, 1608, they were a tired and depleted party. Rory O'Donnell died the same year, and Hugh O'Neill would spend the rest of his life there in Rome in exile, while their lands were given to Scottish and English settlers in the plantation of Ulster. O'Neill continued to write to the Spanish king, urging for an army to be sent to Ireland, but by then England and Spain had made peace, and Ireland was not in anyone's interest anymore. O'Neill died in Rome on the 20th of July, 1616. A sculpture stands now in Rathmullen, remembering the Flight of the Earls. Unveiled 400 years after, in 2007, the sculpture depicts the Earls boarding their ship, hopeful that they will return, and the people of Ireland left behind, sad and desperate. The people of Ireland were left scattered, divided, and leaderless. In the wake of the Flight of the Earls in the following centuries, Ireland suffered the consequences of conquest, famine, war, and conflict with the English. It is one of the key moments in Irish history, and the event still echoes from Lough Swilly throughout Ulster and Ireland to this day. This video was made in conjunction with the Rathmullen and District Local History Society, investing in local history for future generations.
Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon. Also, you can follow me at John D. Ruddy on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. You can support these videos by making a pledge on Patreon. This is hugely helpful in creating new videos. You can get new Manny Man merchandise on johndruddy.com. Check it out. Thanks for watching.